Vancouver self-defense expert is sharing his remarkable story of survival.
But his ordeal did not involve fighting off attackers with a display of martial arts skills.
Instead, his battle was psychological, and his enemy was a powerful and paranoid political regime. Ethan Faber reports.
The moment he comes, hey, leave me alone! And if he comes forward, hey, stop doing this! I told you.
At a self-defense class in East Vancouver, instructor Ralph Haenel teaches the fundamentals.
The very first principle that we learn is to go forward. If he moves in, we're still postponing it for a moment. I don't want to fight, leave me alone. If he does continue, at this moment, we're in there controlling him.
Control is a lesson he's learned the hard way. He began studying martial arts as a teenager in the former East Germany. In 1988, his world turned upside down with an early morning knock on his front door.
Three men were there flipping their IDs, secret police, and so would you please come with us just to clarify the answers to certain questions, so you will be back in time for work.
Haenel was placed under arrest as a political prisoner by the Stasi, one of the communist world's most notorious secret police forces.
At the end of the day, after hours and hours of interrogation about my martial arts activity, about the contact to Western Europe, I was being told it is decided you're here to stay.
It turned out he'd been under surveillance for years. His home had been bugged. The information filled 16 file folders. These photos were taken by informants. His involvement with martial arts was considered subversive, especially his communication with a club in the West.
And since corresponding with this organization requires you leaving a name and a message, this was exchanging messages. So I was officially seen as a spy.
Haenel was taken to a maximum security prison in the city of Rostock. This home video taken years later shows the 70-square-foot cell where he would spend the next 20 months.
No human contact at all, no books. No newspapers, no radio, no television, no personal belongings at all.
As the Berlin Wall began to come down in 1989 and the East German government was collapsing, human rights organizations convinced authorities to release him. He emigrated to Canada and met his future wife, Victoria, and began to put the past behind him.
I don't think that it bothers him in that sense any longer. I think he's one of the few that's been able to turn that around for himself.
Coming around towards me. If this problem is getting big, still stick to it. Don't walk away. You have to face it. Stick to it. Try to work it out. If it gets strong, you may have to yield, but wherever there's a gap, you go forward. Then self-defense, as in real life, the same. Oh, what's happening here?
With 40 students and a young son, Haenel is thriving in his new life. He holds no grudge against his old enemies and, like a true master, uses his ordeal as a source of strength. Ethan Faber, VTV News.
You know, everyone I know who takes martial arts says it's all completely about living a good life, and it helps them get over their problems. It has nothing to do with hitting people or beating people up. It's all about getting through tough times. And that man, of course, is another example of that.
Absolutely. Great story.
Yeah.
Well, apparently, Robbie, we live in the best city in the world for quality of life, and that's according to a new survey. An international human resources consultancy lists Vancouver as the number one place to be.
Well, that...
One place to be.